Sarah, Waleed, terrific work with the headlines, by the way.
I've really enjoyed.
But you know what this show's been missing? Mm-hmm. Some real journalism.
Couldn't agree more, Sam. Here's some stories these nerds wouldn't cover. It's time for News Dump.
News Dump.
It's like a pantomime with this audience. Guys, let's kick it off. OJ Simpson's family have denied requests to study the late football player's brain for CTE, instead donating his body to science. Simpson's family have plans to have him cremated. By cremating him, they're just honouring OJ's final wish: to destroy all evidence.
Disney has threatened lifetime bans for parkgoers who lie about having disabilities after a boom in guests claiming fake medical conditions to skip the long lines. Don't stress, Sam. There's still no word about where they stand on fake make-a-wishes. What about lifetime bans for the most heinous Disney visitors of all, though? Adults with no children. Oh, no. You losers should be on a watch list.
Agree. Now, Gen Z have popularised a new trend: anti-aging straws. Now, influencers believe the odd-shaped straws can help prevent wrinkles, despite no scientific evidence backing this up. Gen Z, I love you. Anti-aging straws. It's so nice. Stay young for as long as you can, because you'll never get to experience adult things like getting a bank loan or buying a house.
69-year-old, perfect age, David Clarkson has broken the Guinness World Record for most pubs visited in 24 hours with 120.
What?
Great work, Dave. He also broke the record for most unanswered "where are you" texts from his missus.
Now, the world's first beauty pageant for AI-generated women has been announced. You heard that correctly. The winner receives a $31,000 first prize. Now, if you thought guys that go to beauty pageants were weird, you should see the creepy guys that go to AI beauty pageants. Hey! Also, this is a win, guys. We've come a long way since the first glitchy prototype a few years ago. Do you guys remember?
I believe that our education, like such as in South Africa, such as...
She wasn't an AI prototype.
Here we go.
Business owner Gene Marks has penned an op-ed in The Guardian claiming he does not mind if his employees take drugs at work. Cannabis, Adderall, Xanax, Ritalin, Vicodin. It's all fair game. Gene, please buy Channel 10. Sarah and I have to hide in the Dunnies to do Nangs.
It was one die.
A family who got their 9-year-old son a pet octopus revealed how it upended their life and destroyed their home after giving birth to 50 babies.
Wow.
Look, my feeling is that the dad should not have slept with the octopus.
Big call, Sam.
But how is it a problem? To me, it sounds like a gift from the gods. Give me a Weber and some lemon juice and I'll sort all this out.
Comedian Tommy Little has dismissed rumours he's going to be the next star of The Bachelor. While he's indeed on the lookout for love, he says the reality TV format isn't for him. He prefers doing it the old-fashioned way. Dowry, making a fair trade for property and livestock. And as we all know, he prefers the crazy chicks on maths.
And finally, Australian Border Force officials have revealed they've intercepted a variety of unusual items at airports, including an aphrodisiac made from donkeys, holy water from the Ganges, dried duck kidneys, and even live toads. Now, I don't condone smuggling things, but you got to respect a guy who can fit all that stuff up his ass. That was New
Zealand. I'm sitting on a pillow.